I'm Laura Blangiardi in Malibu, where the death of a 13-year-old girl leaves her parents fighting for justice. That story coming up next.
I'm Laura Blangiardi in the News 25 newsroom. Coming up next, a high-speed street race leaves two pedestrians dead.
I'm Laura Blangiardi in Pasadena, where the political war is on. That story coming up next. I'm Laura Blangiardi with Seth Green in Hollywood at the premiere of Hatchet 2.
That story
and more coming up next.
Breaking news this morning out of Compton. That's where a massive police search led to the arrest of a murder suspect early this morning. Plus, high-end toys go up in flames. Those stories and more next on News 25 LA.
Reporter Laura Blangiardi joins us from Pasadena with the story. Laura?
That's right, Jay. We're out in front of KPCC Studios where this protest is taking place. If you take a look behind me, you'll notice these demonstrators have an interesting way of making their point. On one side, we have supporters of Carly Fiorina, and across this small driveway here, supporters of Barbara Boxer.
Yes, you did.
No.
Watch it.
Angry faces and loud voices. Those are the only things these two groups have in common. Supporters of Democratic Senator Barbara Boxer and Republican candidate Carly Fiorina squared off practically face to face.
Let's get ready for the next big one tomorrow.
Boxer supporter Guy Johnson helped to rally supporters.
We're here today with these other people to point out that Carly Fiorina stands for more corporate cash, more corporate business to the detriment of progressive people like me. We are here to back Barbara Boxer, who has always supported the working man and the middle class. That's why we're here today.
The protesters set up camp outside KPCC Radio, where Fiorina and Boxer were holding a broadcast debate. Protesters say Republicans are trying to buy the election. Fiorina supporter Kelly Good says Fiorina is good for the state.
I think it's important to get the message out that Carly Fiorina is California's solution right now. She is the answer to a lot of our woes here in California. We're in a dire, dire situation in California. This election has to be taken very, very seriously.
These protesters say they'll be out in full force each time these candidates make a public appearance. From Pasadena, Laura Blangiardi, News 25 LA.
Thanks, Laura, for that report.
These are pictures of Emily Rose Shane taken a month before she was killed. The 13-year-old middle schooler was crushed last April by an out-of-control car on the Pacific Coast Highway. At this news conference, her parents Michelle and Ellen Shane announced a lawsuit against the city and state, demanding one thing.
Change. It's really not about a financial gain. I mean, nothing can replace our daughter. It's about making sure that nobody else ever has to go through this, and a wake-up call to the state and the county.
This makeshift memorial marks the point where 26-year-old Sina Kincanian's car careened into Shane as she was walking home. Witnesses say Kincanian had been speeding on both sides of the highway when his car flipped over and skidded into the pedestrian walkway.
And that's what this lawsuit is about.
Attorney Terry Goldberg says the state has a responsibility to make the roads safer for pedestrians.
The changes that could have taken place here that would have prevented this accident would have been something as simple as a guardrail. We see guardrails along freeways all over Southern California. They have them in stock. It's easy to put them up. That would have prevented the needless death of Emily Shane.
This year alone, 7 people have been killed on PCH, and there have been 376 collisions. The Shanes say they filed the lawsuit in honor of their daughter.
We'll always be sad. You have to go on living. We'll always miss her. And as my husband said, we think of her all the time. There's a huge void that'll never be able to be filled.
City and state officials have 45 days to respond to the lawsuit. Until that time, they will not comment on the case. From Malibu, Laura Blangiardi, News 25 LA.
Hey Los Angeles, I'm Laura Blangiardi with Tinsel Talk. Today we go to Hollywood where Fright fans got a real treat.
From flying hatchets to buckets of blood, you're looking at the latest Hollywood horror film. It's called Hatchet 2, the sequel to the cult classic Hatchet. At its Hollywood premiere, lead actress Danielle Harris talked about the fun she had making this movie.
All these guys that I had to fight in the movie are like 3 times my size, so physically they kicked my ass, but I got him back at the end of the movie, so you'll have to see.
Hatchet 2 is about the hunt for a deformed, psychotic killer in the swamps of New Orleans. Held at the Egyptian Theater, the premiere slash party drew a wide range of celebrity horror fans. Director Adam Green says, if you're not into horror, Hatchet 2 is not for you.
This is not a movie for somebody who's just like passive horror fan who likes, you know, all the remakes and like the PG-13 stuff. Yeah. This is like hardcore, really, really violent, in-your-face makeup effects, but also very, very funny.
While the film is no blockbuster, there's a lot of buzz about it in Tinseltown. Producers say they have a loyal following around the world. Family Guy star Seth Green says he's part of that group.
Just tell me what exactly attracted you to this film.
I love Adam Green. I think Adam Green is a really relevant, hilarious, and exciting filmmaker. He makes awesome horror movies for real horror fans.
Hatchet 2 opens this weekend. For Tinsel Talk, I'm Laura Blangiardi. Good evening. I'm Laura Blangiardi for News 25 LA. Our top story tonight is out of Linwood, where two people were killed because of a street race. The victims were crushed by this car that was racing with another car along Hines Avenue. Witnesses say the victims were walking home from a nearby park. The other driver got away. In Lakewood, another deadly accident to report. This time, it involved a suspected drunk driver. Police found this car wrapped around a telephone pole. The driver died at the scene and her passenger is in critical condition. Police say she and her girlfriend were drinking heavily before the crash. Finally tonight, millions of dollars of high-end vehicles were burned beyond repair. This helicopter, along with a speedboat and racing motorcycle, were destroyed in a fire at this warehouse and museum. The cause of the fire is under investigation. That's going to do it for us tonight. Thank you for watching News 25 LA. I'm Laura Blangiardi. Have a good night.